Tokyo area has two airports. One of the airport, Narita Airport, is located in 70 kilometers, which is 43 miles east of Tokyo city center. Yes, it's far. If your destination is Tokyo and have choice of Narita Airport or Haneda Airport, upon purchasing a ticket, you might want to choose Haneda Airport, which is much closer to Tokyo city center. However, do not worry even if you have tickets to Narita or the flight to Narita is much cheaper. There are several good options that take you to Tokyo city center. Today, I'd like to explain about the three train routes and two bus services from Narita Airport to Tokyo. Let me quickly explain about the Narita Airport's terminal map first. There are three terminals at Narita Airport, Terminal 1, 2, and 3. There is a train station under Terminal 1 which is called Narita Airport Station, and another one is Airport Terminal 2 Station, which is under the Terminal 2. Terminal 1 South Wing is mainly used for ANA and other Star Alliance airlines. Terminal 1 North Wing is mainly used for SkyTeam airlines. Delta has moved all flights to Haneda Airport, so they don't fly to Narita Airport anymore. Terminal 2 is mainly used for Japan Airlines and other Oneworld Alliance airlines. Terminal 3 is used for low-cost carriers for both domestic and international. Probably the most common public transportation from Narita to Tokyo is trains. Two train companies, JR and Keisei, run the special airport express train with reserved seat. JR runs Narita Express and Keisei runs Skyliner. There are also local train tickets to Tokyo city center, and Access Express is an express train that you don't need to get a reserved seat. The destination and prices are different, so you can decide based on your destination, preference, and budget. The merit of using train is the train is fast and it doesn't get influenced by traffic. What I like about the train is usually it's safer and you can walk around unlike the bus. Your trip is not influenced by the driver's techniques too. There are two stations travelers who arrive at Narita Airport will use. Narita Airport Station, which is under the Terminal 1, and Airport Terminal 2 stations, under Terminal 2. You can use both train companies from both stations. So once you arrive and leave custom, proceed to the station in the basement, and you'll find both JR and Keisei stations next to each other. There are some other local trains that are leaving from these two airport stations too, so make sure you are on the right train. For the comfort, I recommend Narita Express or Skyliner, but the Access Express is also useful for visitors too. Let's see one by one. First, Narita Express is operated by JR and it takes you directly to Tokyo Station, Shibuya Station, and Shinjuku Station. It takes about 1 hour to Tokyo Station and 1 hour and 30 minutes to Shinjuku. So it does take time, but it's a great relief that you can go directly to those stations after a long flight. The fare of Narita Express is 3,070 yen to Tokyo Station and 3,250 yen to Shinjuku or Shibuya Station. So to Shinjuku, that'll be 6,500 yen round trip, and that is expensive. If you return in 14 days with Narita Express again, you can consider Narita Express Tokyo round trip ticket, which is 4,070 yen round trip. Make sure you ask that ticket for the staff at the airport station. You can get ticket with reserved seat at the counter and proceed to the platform. Just make sure that you don't get on the local train. Narita Express is a train with red, white, and black design. So, for whom Narita Express is good? Narita Express is good if your final destination is near Tokyo Station, Shibuya or Shinjuku, or if you want to use Japan Rail Pass. Narita Express is a good choice because you can go to Shibuya or Shinjuku directly. If you are planning to use Japan Rail Pass, Narita Express is the only choice as the reserved seats of Narita Express is included in the pass. You need to activate the pass and make sure the seat is reserved before you get on the Narita Express. So make sure you stop at the JR counter, which you can find easily at the gate of JR stations in Narita Airport. Keisei Skyliner is a rapid train service from Narita Airport to Nippori and Ueno stations in Tokyo city center. All seats are for reservation only, and the biggest merit of Skyliner is the speed to the Ueno. It runs with 160 km per 1 hour, which is very fast for non-Shinkansen train in Japan. It takes you to the Nippori station in about 40 minutes. The service runs every 20 to 40 minutes. The fare is 2,590 yen, so a little more reasonable than Narita Express. Keisei's Ueno station is a little far away from JR Ueno station, so if you want to change to JR line, you might want to get off at Nippori station, which is one station before. So, for whom Skyliner is good? Keisei Skyliner is good if your final destination is near Ueno station, or your final destination is on the station easily accessible from Nippori station, such as Akihabara or Ikebukuro. Asakusa is another town that is close to Ueno, but for Asakusa, there is actually another way to go directly too, that I explain after this. Access Express is a regular train that connects Narita Airport and Haneda Airport, which is on the other side of Tokyo. The train uses a fast track called Sky Access, the same as Skyliner, and it takes you to the city center of Tokyo with some stops. The Access Express directly goes into Toei Asakusa Line subway. You don't need any reservation for this train, so the fare will be around 1,300 yen, which is about $10. It's much cheaper than using Skyliner or Narita Express. The major con of Access Express is that it comes only every 40 minutes or so, and it doesn't run in the late night. Also, the train is not just for airport users, so it can be busy in the morning and the evening. You might feel less comfort comparing with reserved seat like Skyliner or Narita Express. Access Express is good if your final destination is along the Toei Asakusa Line subway and cost-conscious travelers who doesn't like the bus. How to get on Skyliner and Access Express? When you get on Skyliner or Access Express, proceed to the platform on Keisei, not JR. After you enter the gate of Keisei, you will see two different platforms for Tokyo directions. One is via Sky Access and one via Keisei Line. You need to go to the platform of Sky Access, not Keisei. It's a little confusing as the destination is the same, but the route via Keisei Line takes much longer time. You use Keisei Line only in case you need to go to Narita City or other destination along Keisei Line. After you reach the platform, make sure you are on the right train with the right ticket. I want you to be careful not to take Access Express with a Skyliner ticket, or take Skyliner without any reserved seat ticket. Especially at Airport Terminal 2 station, both trains come in the same platform. Skyliner is the one with white body and blue design. Access Express is a three door and seats are facing the side of the train. I'm saying this because I saw one guy who purchased a Skyliner ticket, but accidentally got on Access Express. He was sitting next to me and talked to me, "Am I on the right train?" showing me the reserved seat ticket for Skyliner, which was going to leave right after our train. He looked quite upset and I didn't have words to talk to him when Skyliner passed by our train with massive speed, and the silence after that. I don't want any viewers of this channel experience the same thing. Again, Skyliner is a white train with two doors. All seats are facing to the front. Make sure you are on the right train. The bus access between Narita Airport and Tokyo used to be only limousine bus, but recently more reasonable and convenient choices available. Airport bus TYO-NRT is a shuttle service between Narita Airport and Tokyo Station. The bus will take you to Tokyo Station as fast as 65 minutes depending on traffic, and it costs only 1,300 yen one way. The bus runs every 10 minutes to 20 minutes between three terminals of Narita Airport and Yaesu Gate of Tokyo Station. To take the bus to Tokyo, you proceed to the bus tickets counter on the arrival gate and purchase your ticket. It's easy to find the counter, but make sure you get the ticket at this counter before you proceed to the bus. You can get tickets for all bus services from Narita Airport here. Airport bus TYO-NRT is good for you if your final destination is near Tokyo Station. And also, if you are arriving on Airport Terminal 3, you have to walk to the Terminal 2 to take the train, so the bus might be better. Limousine Bus offers bus services between Narita Airport to some destinations in central Tokyo and Haneda Airport. The bus has direct service to major hotels in central Tokyo, so if you are staying at those hotels on the list, this will be a choice. The price is 3,200 yen for adults, so it's a little pricey, but you can skip all the stress of getting on and off at the busy train stations. The bus name is Limousine, but it's pretty much a normal bus with a restroom in the back. The service is very limited, so make sure you check the timetable. So Limousine bus is definitely for you if your hotel is in the list of this bus destination.
This is the boarding call for 1630 buses bound for Haneda Airport from Gate A1, bound for Narita Airport from Gate A2.
I recommend you to choose the easiest way because it's very difficult to change trains with many suitcases after a long flight to Japan. For any travelers, the first thing you want to do is to unload the luggage and make sure you have a good room to sleep that night. So I recommend you to find the easiest route to your accommodation. You can go out for your adventure after that. Or you can even consider choose a hotel that is convenient from Narita Airport for the first night. I hope you got an idea about the transportation from Narita Airport. I hope you have a great week and see you next in the video. Thank you for watching.